Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 3, Episode A7. He'll always be my little brother.
Aku mempunyai adik yang 2 tahun lebih muda. Hari pertama adikku masuk SD, sekolah dasar, aku mengantar dia ke kelasnya sebelum masuk kelas. Sebelum masuk kelasnya, dia bertanya kelas aku di mana dan apakah adikku bisa ke aku kalau dia butuh aku. Aku kasih tahu kelas aku kelas 4A dan aku tunjukkan di mana arahnya. Waktu istirahat, aku langsung lari mendatangi kelasnya. Dari jendela, aku intip dan aku lega. Ternyata dia sudah menemukan teman baru dan bermain bersama. 8 tahun kemudian, walaupun sebenarnya teman dia semakin banyak, bahkan lebih banyak dari aku, tapi waktu aku akan berangkat kuliah ke luar negeri, aku tetap ada rasa khawatir adikku tidak ada teman ngobrol lagi di rumah. Karena biasanya dia banyak bercerita ke aku. Sekarang dia sudah menikah dan mempunyai 3 anak. Tapi buat aku, dia selalu menjadi adikku yang memegang tangan aku dengan ketakutan di hari pertamanya masuk sekolah.
The next one will be the English version of the story.
I have a brother who is 2 years younger. The first day my brother entered elementary school, I took him to his classroom before I went into mine. Before entering his class, he asked me which class I was in and whether he could go to me if he needed me. I let him know that I was in class 4A and showed him where it was. During recess, I immediately ran to his class. Peeking from the classroom window, I was relieved to see that he had made new friends and was playing together. 8 years later, even with an increasing number of friends, he had more friends than I did actually. When the time came for me to go overseas for university, I was still worried that my brother would not have anyone to talk to at home. Usually, I was the one he told stuff to. Now he is married with 3 kids. But for me, he will always be my little brother who was scared and held my hand on his first day of school. As this is one of our editions, as we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we can all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn that how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us.
I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes.
These are our stories. What is yours?